In continuation with this chapter, now in this video we will come to know about the topics like history of electromagnetic waves. Under this topic, we will study about the recognized work of many scientists. Because of them, we are now able to use electromagnetic waves in our day-to-day life. After that, we will study about electromagnetic waves, that is, what is electromagnetic waves, its production, and what is the source of it. We will also draw diagram of electromagnetic wave due to electric field and magnetic field and understand it. We will also study about the wave equation produced due to electric field vector and magnetic field vector. We will study about the important characteristics of electromagnetic wave. So let's begin with history of electromagnetic wave. We had studied in our previous video about Maxwell's four equations, and Maxwell from its four equation theoretically proved that the speed of electromagnetic wave are much closer to the speed of light. Therefore, he proved theoretically that light is an electromagnetic wave. After that, scientist named Hertz experimentally showed electromagnetic wave in a low frequency region. The range of the frequency is 10 raised to the power 5 hertz to 10 raised to the power 9 hertz. And wavelength is of the order greater than 0.1 meter. This order comes under radio waves. In this, we can add that experimentally we still cannot show electromagnetic wave in a higher frequency region because of the non-availability of electronic circuits still in modern electronic circuits. We can detect wave electromagnetic wave of the frequency range equal to 10 raised to the power 11 hertz, and we cannot experimentally demonstrate light as an electromagnetic wave because its range, visible light range, comes in the frequency of 10 raised to the power 14 hertz. That's why Hertz, because of the non-availability of electronic circuit, demonstrated electromagnetic wave in the low frequency region. Now, after 7 years of Hertz experiment, there was one scientist named Jagdish Chandra Bose . He observed and thus produced electromagnetic wave of much shorter wavelength than that of radio waves. Its order is 25 millimeter to 5 millimeter, and frequency is in the range of 10 raised to the power 11 to 10 raised to the power 14 hertz. And this range comes under the wave of infrared waves. And around same time, there was another scientist named Marconi. He established communication between two locations. Around same time, Marconi was a scientist who established communication between two locations which are separated by much more distances of kilometers, and he established relation between these two locations without using wires. So, with the help of electromagnetic waves known as radio waves. So, Marconi was the discoverer or the father of wireless communication. Marconi, because he transmitted communication between two locations located at many kilometers apart. By using radio waves and without wires, thus he is the discoverer of wireless communication and known as father of wireless communication. Because of him, now we are able to broadcast TV and radio, as well as satellite communication is because of wireless communication. Radar, mobile telephone system, that is cellular communication, works on it. GPS, Wi-Fi and Bluetooth we use because of wireless communication. Now let's study about electromagnetic waves. Electromagnetic waves, as the name suggests, the waves which consist electric field as well as magnetic field. And what kinds of electric field and magnetic field it should be? Electric field must be changing with time, as well as magnetic field is changing with time. Then the wave produces is known as electromagnetic wave, and also it should be perpendicular to each other. And electric field and magnetic field both should be perpendicular to the direction of propagation of a wave. So here we can write that electromagnetic waves are the waves which shows sinusoidal variation of electric field and magnetic field, which are oscillating at right angle to each other also both electric field and magnetic field are at right angle to the direction of propagation of a wave. Now, how electric and magnetic field vary with time? As we know that a wave is a form of energy, and energy propagates to one point to other. And when we are considering a charge which is at rest, then it produces only electric field because of this charge. And when the charge is in uniform motion, then it produces uniform velocity. And because of the motion of a charge, electric as well as magnetic field produces. And here velocity is constant, therefore there is no acceleration of a charge. Because of that, there is no change in electric field and magnetic field with respect to time. Therefore, it is necessary to take an accelerated charge, that is, in which the velocity is changing with time. And velocity will not be constant during motion of a charge. And because of that, there is a change in electric field and magnetic field with respect to time. This production of electromagnetic wave is because of the accelerated charge, and the example of accelerated charge is the oscillation of charge. Example of accelerated charge is oscillation of a charge. And thus we conclude that the source of electromagnetic wave is a accelerated charge. Now let's draw the important diagram of electromagnetic wave. Consider x, y, and z coordinate axis. And let x-axis shows the direction of propagation of a wave. Electric field is along y-axis and magnetic field is along z-axis. So due to accelerated charge, there is a production of electric field which is oscillating. That is, oscillating electric field is produced due to accelerated charge in y direction, which is the velocity is changing with time, having different amplitudes, this is the maximum amplitude of electric field. And at the same time, this electric field will produce oscillating magnetic field along z-axis, which is at right angle to this electric field. Now, this in turn produces electric field. Which is also oscillating electric field. And at the same time, this oscillating electric field will produce oscillating magnetic field. Then this oscillating magnetic field will produce electric field. And this electric field will in turn produces magnetic field. This is magnetic field. Thus, here we can see that electric field are generating oscillating magnetic field and oscillating magnetic field are generating oscillating electric field at the same time and so on. Thus, electromagnetic wave are propagating along x direction and here therefore we can say that electromagnetic waves are self-sustaining waves. They regenerates each other. Also, we can consider this region as the envelope of electric field vector and this is the envelope of magnetic field vector. Now let's study the wave equation of electric field and magnetic field vector. Electric field vector along y-axis can be written in terms of magnitude and direction. And magnitude is equal to E naught. As the wave is a progressive wave, so we are writing here the equation of progressive wave, that is E naught sine kx minus omega t j cap. Progressive wave is that wave which are traveling from one point to another point. So here electric field is changing or oscillating with respect to time and here the direction we are considering as positive direction as the wave is propagating along positive x-axis. So we are writing equation kx minus omega t. If the propagation of wave is along negative x-axis, then here we will take equation as kx plus omega t. So here we are considering positive x-axis, that is why kx minus omega t j cap, where this kx minus omega t is the phase and initial phase is phi 0 which is equal to 0 here in this case and E naught is the amplitude of a traveling wave or amplitude of oscillation k is known as propagation constant or angular wave number. Its value is given as 2 pi by lambda and its SI unit is radian per meter. and omega is angular frequency. Given as 2 pi nu. And x is a distance or a position on the direction of propagation. Distance on axis of propagation of a wave. This is the equation of electric field vector in terms of wave equation. And similarly, magnetic field vector can be written in terms of magnitude and direction. Magnitude is equal to its amplitude of oscillation, sine kx minus omega t, as the wave is propagating along x-axis. Now, the speed of electromagnetic wave is given as velocity is equal to angular frequency by propagation constant k. And here, as we know that this velocity is equal to the speed of light, so we can replace v by c. That is, speed of electromagnetic wave. This all we had studied in our 11th class in the chapter waves and oscillation. As v is equal to c, therefore c is equal to omega by k. And later we will study that c is equal to 1 upon mu naught epsilon naught, that is permeability of free space and permittivity of free space. Also, we can write that omega is equal to c into k, and substitute the value of omega and k here. Omega is 2 pi nu and k is 2 pi by lambda. By this we get nu is equal to c by lambda, or c is equal to nu into lambda. Now let's study the important characteristics of electromagnetic waves. These all equations you need to remember for numericals point of view. In boards, generally 3 to 4 characteristics are asked. The most important characteristic of electromagnetic wave is it is radiated or produced by accelerated charge. And the second important one is it do not require material medium to propagate. It can propagate with the speed of light in vacuum. Thus, the third important one characteristic is in free space, it can travel with the speed of light. एंड दस इफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक वेव ट्रेवल इन डाइलेक्ट्रिक देन इट्स वेलोसिटी और स्पीड विल डिक्रीज. And the fourth important one is electromagnetic waves are self-sustaining waves. That is, oscillating electric and magnetic field regenerate each other. Or as the time passes, electromagnetic waves do not require accelerated charge to propagate, as only electric and magnetic field will regenerate each other, and also the amplitude of electric and magnetic field. Is equal to the speed of light. Fifth important characteristic is electromagnetic waves are transverse waves. That is, oscillating electric field and magnetic field or variation in it are perpendicular to each other. Perpendicular to each other as well as perpendicular to the direction of propagation of wave. Thus, electromagnetic waves are transverse in nature. And the sixth characteristic is frequency of electromagnetic wave are equal to the frequency of oscillation of electric charge. Thus, frequency of electric field and magnetic field are also same as that of frequency of oscillation of electric charge. And the seventh characteristic is, as electromagnetic wave are transverse in nature, therefore the energy of electromagnetic wave are equally divided into energy density of electric field and energy density of magnetic field. That is, average or total average energy density are equally divided between electric energy density due to electric field and magnetic energy density due to magnetic field, and it is equal to electric एनर्जी डेंसिटी इज इक्वल टू हाफ एप्सिलॉन नॉट ई स्क्वायर एंड मैग्नेटिक एनर्जी डेंसिटी इज हाफ बी स्क्वायर बाय म्यू नॉट.